The Heart of Christ Church presents Moments from the Heart.
Hello, and welcome to Moments from the Heart, a ministry of the Heart of Christ Church here in Lebanon, Pennsylvania. I'd like to welcome you once again to our time of study together for these moments of encouragement. And I'd just like to remind you of where we are and what we're doing. We've been speaking on a scripture from the third chapter of Colossians. This would be our third installment, so to speak, of the lessons that we're trying to learn through verse 12, which speaks to us as God's chosen people and how we ought to live our lives. We've already spoken on compassion and kindness, and today we're going to be talking about humility. So I'd like to get into the word once again, just to remind you of the word that we're studying, and then look at the truth that comes from the Word of God into our lives, and to make us a part of who He is and a part of who we are always to be. So if you would, turning in your scriptures from the 12th verse of the third chapter of the book of Colossians, we read these words. It says, "Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other and forgive whatever grievances you may have against one another. Forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these virtues, put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity." Blessed be the word of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. As we look at the word humility, we have an understanding of the word of humility in our culture today, because people who are humble, people who truly live lives of humility are raised up in some circumstances. In others, they're trodden over because our society looks at people as wanting them to be go-getters and out there in the face of things. But God tells us that humility is a great attribute. It's a virtue according to these scriptures, and I believe that. Because humility truly looks at oneself and understands one's position, but then does not use that position as an authority or a right over and above others. We know that we are God's chosen people. So therefore, what rights do we have? We have the rights to all the promises of God. But yet, Jesus didn't live that way when he was here on earth. Jesus lived as a servant unto mankind. And that is how we're to model our lives after his ministry here on earth, as he showed us how to live unto the second coming. And so when we think about humility, we need to think about just what did Jesus do, and you know, how would we try to be like him? I have a professor who hated the statement, what would Jesus do? And then we're supposed to try and figure that out. Well, we don't have the mind of Jesus, so we really would not be able to figure that out. However, I do believe the Word gives us a wonderful example, and we're to come as close to it as we can. So when we think about the humility of Christ, he knew that he was the Son of God. He knew he had all the power and the authority of everything. Yet he lived as a servant. He lived to serve others. And that's the humility that's being spoken of here. Remembering our position, remembering who we are, but yet submitting to the authorities that are over us and working with those around us to raise them up. Understanding that part of the reason that we have the position that we do is because it was given to us. It was a gift to us. We've been adopted in. And as we think of ourselves, we need to think of others that are to come along as well, that they are no better or no worse than we are. When we think about humility, we need to think about all the Proverbs, all the Psalms that speak of humility. Jesus, when he taught on the Sermon on the Mount, when he spoke on humility. In each of those cases, we find that God wants us, the people of promise, the people who are storing up treasures in heaven, because remember, we're not storing up treasures here on earth. God gives us blessings here on earth to use while we're here for His purposes and His plans, to bring forth the kingdom of Christ here on this earth. But we're storing up treasures in heaven. So as we walk in humility, as we treat our brothers and sisters as better than ourselves, we are living out the word that tells us that we are to think of ourselves with sober judgment, not think of ourselves more than we ought, but thinking of others before us. And as we do that, as we live that life, we bring people along with us. As we spoke on the compassion and kindness, it's something that lasts and sticks around, and it allows us to raise up somebody else to a position that they should be into. Because there are so many people that are broken in our world today, and so many broken people need others coming around them, not in arrogance, not in austerity, but in humility, to raise them up and allow them to see that where I am, you may be also. And that's what humility speaks. Where I am, you may be also. And in that reality of being raised up, then you too need to be like me and humble in spirit, realizing that this is a gift. This is a grace given us by God. And in that grace, we can make it through every day by sharing what we have and who we are with other people. So when you think about the humility, it's not a detriment. It's actually an attribute. It is a positive reality into our world that draws others into the heart of Jesus Christ. And that's what we're here for, to be transformed to the heart of Jesus Christ. And humility is one of the greatest aspects that God uses. So this week, as you're out there and you see somebody in need, I pray that you would show them the compassion of God. I pray that you would show them the kindness of God. I pray that you would show them the humility of God that is in you through the power of the Holy Spirit, and is to be used for God's glory to raise others up. And in so doing, God will raise you up. This has been Pastor Rich, Moments from the Heart. May God bless your every moment.
You have been watching a Bible teaching from the Heart of Christ Church. You can find us on the web at www.theheartofchristchurch.com. If you have found benefit in listening to this message, you can send us an email from our contact page, or if you would like to donate or write to us, do so at P.O. Box 1011, Quentin, PA 17083.